Well, the pre-opening rates are with us, and at the moment, I think it's starting with almost 0.5% gain. But let's see how things pan out. Reliance, I think, will have a lot of positives coming its way. We just got the Rel Jio numbers that were very positive, and I think some initial moves to also acquire Arcom's landed assets may be afoot. Therefore, we are seeing strong numbers. Reliance start off with 1%, but again, now it's gone down. Yeah. 0.5% now. Ultratech Cement is starting with about 2.7%. But let's wait and see. I think the market is still zigzagging a bit. Let's wait for things to settle down. The rupee has opened really strong.
Yeah.
I mean, this is huge. I guess it's a testimony to the amount of dollar flows.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, the strength in the rupee continues. A couple of pockets may be in focus today. The aviation space is under a lot of pressure. Interglobe Aviation is down almost about 0.5%. You have Jet Airways that showed a red take initially. Of course, air passenger traffic growth has slowed down to a five-year low. So that is reflecting there. A couple of more stocks you'd want to look at. Jubilant Life should come up for you, actually. There's some negative news on Jubilant Life, where their facility in Mysore has been classified as an OAI, or Official Action Indicated, which means that the probability of a warning letter rises. So that stock is in the red right now. But we'll wait by for these rates to settle, as Lata said. For now, all we can say is that the market may open a tad bit in the green, continuing with the strong trajectory that we've seen over the last fortnight. SP Tulsian of SPTulsian.com is joining us now. Mr. Tulsian, good morning. I wanted your thoughts on, you know, how to approach the entire aviation space now. Not just Jet Airways, I mean, that's a separate story. But, you know, this whole slowdown in the air passenger growth, rising fares resulting in weak demand. You think it's going to go through a rough patch, both SpiceJet and Interglobe? Or would you buy into the dip of any of these stocks?
No, Sonia, actually buying the, firstly, we are extremely positive on the aviation sector going forward because of the approaching holiday seasons coming in. Maybe the vacation and all that will start with the end of, or maybe middle of April, which will last till middle of June. So keeping positive view, but if you really take a call on the SpiceJet and Indigo, both have seen having risen. Maybe Indigo is ruling at 100 rupees lower than its 52-week high of 1500, 1520 to 1420. Similar is the case with the SpiceJet. So yes, the share prices have risen. In fact, a lot of frenzy was seen day before on Wednesday. So probably one can look to buy both the stocks of this SpiceJet and Indigo 5% lower than the current price because of the positive I've seen continuing. Coming specifically on Jet, you know, this is seen to be a high risk, high return stocks. The way things are panning out, it takes time, but you know, the clearances from the North Block, having had SBI, you know, had a discussion with North Block on Wednesday, and then thereafter the kind of progress which we have been seeing, where the Naresh Goyal is seen to have been, you know, forced to cut his stake below 10%, which is a condition, you know, maybe having imposed by the prospective buyer in the airlines, are also seen to be quite positive. The moment we will see any type of positive news coming in, that will also make the Jet Airways also share to fly. So yes, positive view on all three stocks going forward.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. Tulsian. Well, I wanted to ask you, what does a Mindtree investor do now? Looks like the buyback hasn't called back. Now, L&T looks like we'll be able to force the issue and do open offer and buy the stock. But there is every danger that the founders will also move out. So there could be an earnings issue there if the cream moves out. The minority investor is genuinely confused. What would you advise him?
See, Lata, this is what I've said, that, you know, if you really take the call on the valuation of the Mindtree, having L&T having acquired the stake at 980, the share has risen by about 100 rupees. And if you take the, you are right that yes, the fear of the founders, you know, seen moving out can give a knee-jerk reaction to the earnings, and you know, there will be integration pain also. Though there is no capability doubts on the there is no doubt on the capability of the L&T group, because they are running two efficient companies, L&T Infotech and L&T Technology Services. So I don't have doubt, but yes, the knee-jerk reactions or maybe the integration pain for 6 months may always be seen if the existing promoters move out, you know, which are a group of 5-6 people. So yes, that's what the coming on the valuation, that's what I've said, that the Mindtree is already ruling at the rich valuations, and you know, maybe at a P multiple of about 17-18 based on the FY20 earnings. While the if you take the call on the HCL take, that is the leading one is ruling at a P multiple of maybe 14-15. So there is no harm in exiting the stock from the for those who have the fear. If you have the 1 year view, then it is advisable always that you move out at the current level. But if you are keeping a long term view, because the once the L&T will go ahead with his with its buyback plan and you know this open offer, and they will ramp up their stake to 51%. Even P expansion will happen because mind it that L&T twins are ruling at a P multiple of 20-21 based on FY20 earnings. So yes, that advantage is also there. But on a risk reward for the near term investors or maybe those who have a view of just 6 months, it is better for them to exit from the stock at the current level.
Okay, well, Maruti continues to be under pressure, so keep an eye out on that stock. In fact, not just Maruti, a couple of other heavyweight auto stocks too, like Eicher Motors, are down almost about 0.5% or so. Mr. Tulsian, I also want to ask you about, you know, Reliance and the wireless data that has come through. But before that, we have Manisha Gupta who joins in to give us an update on the commodity space because Brent continues to be at 2019 highs. Hi, Manisha. Good morning. What do you have for us?
Morning, Sonia. Thank you so much for that. Well, yes, Brent is trading at a four-month highs, and we are up 26% now for the Brent prices in this year. It has to do with the supply cuts led by the OPEC. Now, OPEC and allies account for 45% of global oil output. So while we are looking at various other factors, this is one thing that has continued to drive the prices higher. And we have seen five straight weeks of money managers and hedge funds continue to deploy money on net longs in case of crude. So some more strength expected here. And as far as the Brent goes, I think we are inches away from $70 per barrel. And markets do believe that any further upside from here of about half a dollar might really take us to 70 sooner than later. Markets also are looking at strength in the metal space, where you have the gold prices holding above $1,300 per ounce. It is about dovish Fed, slower economic growth, Brexit uncertainties, U.S. and China trade talks. All of that has led to support in gold as well. When it comes to the industrial metals, while, of course, we have seen some profit taking come in for Shanghai, and this is after U.S. says that they may leave tariffs on Chinese goods for a substantial period to ensure that China complies with any trade agreement, is something that really seems to have led to some profit taking. The U.S. trade delegation will meet China on March 28 and 29. So any statements out of that in next week is where the markets will take further cues from. But having said that, when you look at metals like nickel, zinc, copper, tin, steel, etc., they are between 7 to 20% higher for 2019 till now. So while markets, of course, are keeping in mind the U.S., the China stimulus measures and the second season of the second quarter of this 2019, which is expected to be a seasonally strong demand period, all of those factors are supportive, but it really has to be about the U.S. dollar, the U.S. and China trade talks that is keeping the market slightly uncertain.
Okay. Yes. At the moment, the dollar has dipped, and that's giving emerging market currencies a bit of a leg up. Thank you very much, Manisha, for putting all the other cues on the table. Mr. Tulsian, I wanted to actually ask the same Reliance question to you. The Rel Jio subscribers have gone up, but there is also some report in the report to the exchange that RIL has incorporated a company with 5 lakh rupees. It's called Reliance Navi Mumbai Infra Limited. The guess would be that that is to acquire Arcom's landed assets, maybe, when it comes into the NCLT. How do we put all this for a Reliance investor into perspective?
See, Lata, quickly coming on the Reliance Jio number accretion, yes, that seemed positive. But coming on the second news of incorporating the company, this news, I think, has got missed out by the public or maybe by the media, that Reliance has already paid last week, about 10 days back or maybe 7 days back, 2,180 crore for acquiring stake in Navi Mumbai SEZ, which has a 4,000-acre land. And for the first time, Maharashtra government has innovated a new concept, integrated industrial area, which we need to understand. This will be a form of the industrial corridors plus SEZ, combination of both, because we have very well understood the concept of SEZ, but this new concept, integrated industrial area, for the first time has been chalked out by Maharashtra government, on which this 4,000 acre will get developed. And now this Navi Mumbai SEZ, in which they have paid 2,180 crores, the Reliance Industries has not defined the terms. But that NMSEZ, Navi Mumbai SEZ, has 26% stake by the government, that is Maharashtra authority, and 74% by JACOP and other investors, you know. And that is, and maybe even the Mukesh Ambani in his personal capacity already holding that. So that land parcel of 4,000 crore, which is very big, you know, will get developed. And probably maybe to develop that parcel, this company must have been incorporated.
Okay.
I don't think that it has anything to do at this stage for development of the Dhirubhai Ambani Knowledge City, you know, which is held by the ARCOM. So this is my guess, and this is coming on that earlier 2,180 crore, which Reliance Industries has already paid, is seen to be having extremely immense potential for the real estate development to JCOP as well as to Reliance Industries going forward.
Okay. Well, for now, we have about 4.5 minutes left. Mr. Tulsian, I also want your view on paint companies, because CLSA has downgraded some of them, you know, on the back of the slowdown in the auto sector. But I'll come to that in a bit. Let's get some 9-10 calls going. Ashwini, the market looks like it's set to start higher. But what would your big call be at 9-10?
I think financials will continue to outperform, because Bank Nifty is opening up 88 points. Individual stocks, HDFC is a buy with a stop of 1975, target of 2010. And we had a narrow range on Wednesday on the Nifty. So possibly Nifty could pick up from here as well and get past 11,600.
Okay. Mitesh, what would be your 9-10 call?
Yeah, I will choose a buy on Indiabulls Housing with a stop at 715 for targets of 765.
Okay. Prakash?
I think I'll go with Canfin Homes. Certainly looks good to me. Target on the upside 340, stop below 320.
Okay. I just wanted to point out, Kansai Nerolac has taken a bit of a beating. It's understandable. They are big suppliers to Maruti.
Yes.
And they also got a downgrade from one of the brokerages. So that stock is starting 3.7 down. At the moment, the Interglobe is starting lower, and so is Chalet Hotels. I mean, if you keep on pricing air tickets higher, I guess immediately there's a negative reaction on hotels as well.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the demand slowdown is real, and you know, it's having ramifications on many of these
sectors.
At least
in the short run.
But
yeah.
Mr. Tulsian, you know, I wanted to come to you on this CLSA downgrade on paint companies. They've downgraded Kansai. They've cut the target price to 385. We know that paint companies like Kansai get 1/3 of their revenues from the auto sector. Do you fear some earnings cuts here?
See, Sonia, if you take the overall call on the paint sector, definitely auto consumption will be seen as negative for them. But the affordable housing, or maybe the overall real estate sector development, which we will be seeing from 1st April, will largely get offset. Now, it depends on each company what kind of presence they have. If they are into the decorative paint and, you know, in the catering to the housing sectors, then they may not get affected like Asian Paints or, and, you know, but maybe stocks, because there are only 4 or 5 listed companies in the paint sector. So maybe this can be seen as a near term, because it is not acceptable that this slowdown of the auto will last beyond June. You know, this seems to be the understanding also. And apart from that, if you see the crude, you know, now seem to be stable, Brent at $67-$68, but they have been benefited because of the strong rupee. When you have seen the crude ruling at 65-66 barrel, at that time rupee was 70-71-72. Now crude is seen at, Brent is seen at, stabilized at 68, but the rupee is seen quite strong, maybe sub 69. So that is giving advantage of the margin accretion also to the paint companies. So we won't be keeping the negative view. Maybe Kansai Nerolac as such has been non-performer in the paint sector, but Berger and Asian Paints looks to be a good buys even at the current level, in spite of having run up quite a lot.
All right. We'll leave it at that, Mr. Tulsian. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. We will, of course, need your help during closing bell as well. There's still a minute to go. I want to point out that today financials could have a leg up from the bond markets, because bond yields have opened about 2 basis points lower. This is partly following what's happening in the United States as well. So three basis points lower when it opened, 7.34. 7.48 on the old tenure, and on the new tenure as low as 7.32. That's 4 basis points lower. You did point out to Indiabulls, Ashwini. In fact, all three of you pointed out to Indiabulls Housing. Any other financials that you would watch out for?
Basically, the same set of private financials should move higher. In fact, Bank Nifty started its rally on Wednesday itself, and today it should continue.
Okay, well, actually, PNB is moving higher. I cannot understand arrest or even extradition of Nirav Modi. You should have money to pay back 13,000 crores. I don't think getting him how it's going to be positive. But PNB is the best performing stock at the moment in the banking space. I mean, I can't see the connection. It'll be good for India that, you know, you're able to force the law. But PNB, I don't think, can get any money out of the man since most of his assets are now sealed or seized. But the stock is up.